So let's discuss historical background. So impact of in the major driving factor was driving force behind this coming up of 1833 Act, or that influenced the provisions of 1833 Act, was Industrial Revolution. Good afternoon, friends. Today our topic of discussion is Act of 1833, which is also known as Charter Act of 1833. Charter Act of 1833. Why it is known as Charter Act of 1833? Because whenever there was some company, that British government, they used to give permission to the joint stock company, which was English East India Company. So that permission was in the form of written documents which contain certain rules and regulations regarding their performance, regarding their authority. So in a way, it was controlled by British government, or more precisely British Parliament. So British came out with this novel idea of giving 20-year charter to the English East India Company. So after every 20 years, English East India Company was getting one charter and further extension. Okay, so before getting into the topic, let's discuss general features or general happenings which were occurring at this particular during this phase. So by 1833, it was very clear that British are going to be the masters of Indian subcontinent, or a major power in Indian subcontinent, and no power could match their authority, no power could match their military might. Okay, so now on Indian soil, the Britishers, they were all powerful militarily, politically, administratively, socially, and more importantly, commercially, because they were using their politico-administrative power for the purpose of furthering their commercial interest. Fine. But we see in the previous charter acts, here we are discussing Charter Act of 1833, but if we in a separate lecture we will discuss Charter Act of 1813. In that particular Charter Act, under certain compulsions or due to certain pressures, British Parliament, it ended the monopoly of English East India Company. It ended the monopoly of British East India Company, and the monopoly only remain in trade with China and टी. तो चाय और चाइना, इन दो चीजों में, इन दीज टू थिंग्स, दे हैव द इंग्लिश ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी, दे हैड देयर मोनोपोली. अदरवाइज रेस्ट ऑफ द ट्रेड वॉज थ्रोन ओपन टू ऑल यूरोपियंस. all Europeans can go, they can establish their factory or they can establish their market, they can sell their product, they can earn their profit. Okay, so things were becoming already becoming difficult for English East India Company. And now things will be now English East India Company will loosen its further control by this very Charter Act of 1833, which is also important from prelims and mains point of view, not only from prelims mains point of view, but also from GS and history optional point of view. Because it is a major landmark, it is a major milestone in the constitutional development of British Paramountcy. Over the Indian territories. Fine. So now Bengal was defeated. Okay, Mysore was defeated by this time. Marathas were defeated by this time, and states, even the Mughal emperor, he was getting pension of 26 lakhs from the Britishers only, and the Nawab of Awadh, he was on the mercy of British East India Company. So they are virtually most powerful entity on Indian subcontinent. Only few areas were like Punjab, Afghanistan, they were outside their ambit. And later on, as the things progresses, we will see these areas would be also coming within their fold, within their, under their military might. Okay, so let's discuss what constitute the historical background. ऐसा तो है नहीं कि चार्टर एक्ट बनाने का ख्याल जो है आउट ऑफ द ब्लूज इट केम इन टू द माइंड ऑफ ब्रिटिश पार्लियामेंट दैट लेट्स रिपील चार्टर एक्ट 1813 एंड ब्रिंग चार्टर एक्ट ऑफ 1833 बिकॉज वी सी दैट 20 years lease was given to English East India Company. So after 1813 plus 20, it is 1833. So what is coming? So it was obligatory for British Parliament to come up with some legislative enactment to compel or to contain the power, influence and authority of British East India Company. And it's not that British Parliament was doing it deliberately. There were certain forces, there were certain historical developments which were happening back home in London, where certain sections were exerting pressure over the British Parliament that the control over India solely of English East India Company has to go. Because we see that till this time bicharo ke paas sirf trade with China or tea bacha hua hai, but still they have administrative control, military control of India. Okay, so let's discuss historical background. So impact of the major driving force behind this coming up of 1833 Act, or that influenced the provisions of 1833 Act, was Industrial Revolution. Industrial Revolution created a class of entrepreneurs who had a firm belief in free trade. Free trade. But do you think that free trade would survive when already there is a East India Company, when there is a East India Company who is enjoying a monopoly over India, commercial monopoly over India? So this thing has to go. And this lobby of entrepreneurs, or the sometimes we call them industrial bourgeoisie, they had this thing, they wanted free trade, they wanted free access to India, not only for them but all Europeans they wanted, be it French, German, everyone, that the control and monopoly of English East India has to go. So it was under the impact of Industrial Revolution. English Industrial Revolution did not simply mean change in mode, method of production. What is change in mode and method of production? The factory system was coming up, and machine made cheap products were coming up. 1833 ke saath saath aapka thoda sa, I am giving you a brief overview of Industrial Revolution also. So machine made products are also coming up, so that also brought the surplus manufacturers, they needed market for their product, finished products, and market India jaisa market kahan milega. Okay, so these lobbies now, due to certain acts, due to certain political developments in Britain, they have gained considerable political strength, and they are now very influential in British Parliament. So they were putting lot of pressure that to, for the purpose of export expansion, or to locate new markets or new avenues of raw materials for the machines, the monopoly has to go. So already there was a kind of widened social outlook. Social outlook got widened because of certain thinkers like Adam Smith. We will discuss about Adam Smith and his theory of laissez-faire. Where he discussed about capitalism. And capitalism, the word he used, that is the capital which is generated as a surplus should be reinvested in the factors of production, in the process of production, to generate more profit. This is primary accumulation of capital. Okay, we will discuss in detail what is primary accumulation of capital and what is secondary accumulation of capital. And where did primary accumulated capital went, and where did the second secondary accumulation of capital went. Okay, so there was a kind of widened social outlook because society is changing. There is a lot of prosperity in London. The new class emerged, and this is different from the feudal landowning class of the Middle Ages. Now there is a new class which believes in profit, which believe in a new way of life, which believe in a spirit of independence. Now new class consciousness was also coming. I told you that industrial bourgeoisie created pressure. This bourgeoisie was nothing but they were industrial owners. They were the owners, or they were the capitalists. But do you think that capitalists used to work in the assembly line? Assembly line होता है किसी भी factory में जहाँ पे product बनते हैं और finished products they are assembled for the purpose of export or for the purpose of loading. Okay? वहाँ पे सारी each and every machine is there. Each and every activity happens there. So this is assembly line. So do you think that they used to work? No. So in apart from this bourgeoisie, what came on the scene was a working class which was poor, which was not privileged, and they are also known as proletariat. Marx called them proletariat. So new class consciousness is coming. Earlier yesterday's lecture we have discussed during the feudalism system, those who are owning land, and those, the differentiation was those who are owning land and those who are working on those land. Mai baap ka rishta wo hoga, lekin ab mai baap ka rishta jo hai wo different hoga. Ab capitalist or working class, now there is a new class consciousness. This bourgeoisie, they will feel that they are a privileged class, and the working class, they will think that because they are poor because of these capitalists, because all surplus labor, their all hard work, all profit is going into the pocket of capitalists. So new class consciousness was coming up. So this new class consciousness, it also created political movements. जब society में change होंगे तो polity में तो change होंगे ही होंगे, that is for sure, that is inevitable. Okay, so number of political movements were happening for betterment of condition of working class, or certain political movements were happening in parliament for giving more representation to the newly emerging middle class, newly emerging professional class of capitalists. So this has its own socio-political implications. And apart from this capitalist and working class, there due to education was rising, population was rising. This was the time when due to development in medicine, the field of medicine, their cure of many diseases were found. So as a result, people were now no longer believing in superstition that church will do this, pope will cure this diseases. थोड़े बहुत तो बिलीव सभी करते हैं, बट मेजॉरिटी ऑफ द यूरोप वॉज हैविंग दिस अवेकनिंग बिकॉज ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन एंड देयर पॉपुलेशन वॉज राइजिंग बिकॉज ऑफ डेवलपमेंट्स, बिकॉज ऑफ प्रॉस्पेरिटी एंड बिकॉज ऑफ द इम्प्रूवमेंट्स इन मेडिकल साइंस नॉलेज. ओके, सो the rest of the class, what is a concomitant growth of this entire thing was growth of intelligentsia. Intelligentsia means the educated class or the intellectual class. Okay, education was rising. So when education was rising, so new class of intelligentsia came up on the scene. Apart from the socio-economic developments, there were certain political developments. I told you that political movements must be happening, and these political developments were the earlier there were pressure groups came up in British polity. But later on, these pressure groups took the form of political party system So in Britain, two political parties emerged, Whigs and Tories. These Whigs, they were radicals or they were pro-changers. रेडिकल जो होगा वो चेंज ओरिएंटेड होगा, कंजर्वेटिव जो होगा वो स्टेटस को ओरिएंटेड होगा. कंजर्वेटिव टोरीज वर कंजर्वेटिव. सो इन 1830 विग्स केम इनटू पावर. सो इफ द रेडिकल्स हैव कम इनटू पावर, सो दे विल सीक सर्टेन चेंजेस. Already there is a pressure of capitalists and I also told you that enlightenment has happened, new intelligentsia has came up in the society. Okay, so you see that the developments which were happening in 19th century India, the social awakening which is happening in case of India, this awakening was happening in case of Europe much earlier. वो जो बोलते हैं ना कि वो लोग हमसे 150-200 साल आगे हैं, तो वो difference वहीं से start हुआ है. Okay, because the beginning of modern age in Europe, it happened in 15th century, and in Indian case it's only after India was welded into a nation and social awakening movements they happened due to influence of Western education, due to coming into exposure with the Western ideals of liberty of thought or speech and expression, everything, this freedom of expression, all these things, they came into India indirectly through British rule. We got this exposure from them only. So political developments, coming of Whigs into power in 1830, and new political culture characterized by liberal principles like rights of man, dignity of mankind. I told you that there was a rise of intelligentsia, and this intelligentsia was a firm believer in popular rights or rights of people, civil liberties, dignity of mankind, and the rights of man as an individual. Okay? And between it, after the Whigs came into power, they passed the Great Reform Act of 1832. This is an important topic which we will be taking separately, but I am telling you in brief. This Great Reform Act of 1832, it brought British Parliament, or the allocation of seats in British Parliament in congruence with the new demographic pattern. It led to the redistribution or reallocation of seats. Pehle kya tha? What the practice was earlier, most of the seats, they were given to the boroughs or the areas which were land owning classes were having sufficient control or having more control. So they used to purchase, sometimes they used to purchase the seats in British Parliament. But now what is happening? Capitalists are coming. So, and some new cities also sprang up where industrial revolution is happening, such as Manchester, Birmingham, London. So new cities are coming up. Earlier these cities were normal, they were poor, but now they are gaining economic and financial strength. तो उन्हें भी तो रिप्रेजेंटेशन चाहिए, पॉलिटिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन, तभी तो सड़कें बनेंगी. ओनली देन द फिजिकल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर एंड सोशल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर वुड ग्रो. ओके, सो इकोनॉमिक डॉक्ट्रिन्स ऑफ लेजिस्फेयर. आई टोल्ड यू दैट लेजिस्फेयर मींस फ्री ट्रेड. सो दिस the intelligentsia like Adam Smith in his book Wealth of Nations he discussed about laissez-faire, and in fact he supported that laissez-faire should be there and monopoly, any kind of monopoly should go. So there was an overall, there was an atmosphere of reform and liberal ideas. And this is happening in Britain. And why? Because of industrial revolution, main factor industrial revolution. And all these social, political, economic development, these are happening because of industrial revolution. The force is unleashed by the industrial revolution. Okay, so questions were getting raised over continuance of companies' rule over India as well. That whether a colony like India should remain under monopoly control of company or not, or it should be left open for all. So the purpose of 1833 Act was this only, and I told you that it ended, only two things were left: trade with China and trade in tea. And these two things, they also went away with the Act of 1833 Act. Okay, So Macaulay was there. He was secretary to the Board of Control. Board of Control, it came earlier. It was part of the constitutional development only. So Macaulay, who was there, and James Mill, who was there, they said that company, there should be relaxation in companies' control over India, but companies' rule should not go altogether. Okay, so and the designation of the Governor General of Bengal or Governor General of Fort William should be changed as Governor General of India, and therefore William Bentinck became first Governor General of India. So we discussed in Regulating Act that first Governor General of Bengal or first Governor General of Fort William, who was Warren Hastings, but the first Governor General of India would be William Bentinck, and he would be now the Governor General would become virtual master or virtual ruler of India, as we will see in the provisions of this act. Okay, so let's discuss the provisions. So companies' monopoly over trade with China and trade in tea also ended. Their 20 years lease, I told you that they were given after every Charter Act, they were given 20 years lease. So they were allowed to continue till 1853. Fir 1853 mein ek fir se ek Charter Act aayega, and there will be certain changes. Okay, so territories of India, now they are to be governed by the English East India Company as a trustee of the British Crown. As it now, the company will rule, company will remain. Dekho, trade khatam ho gaya hai. Trade has gone from the hands of East India Company. So no, company bachi kya fir? Company is simply now an administrative body. Company became an administrative body, and they have to rule India. They have to rule India in the name of British Crown. Okay. Further, the interest of shareholders, because we have seen earlier also that company ki to hal kharab ho raha hai, commercial उसका जो प्रिविलेज जो मोनोपोली है दैट इज गोइंग, बट द शेयर होल्डर दे वर कंसर्न दैट व्हाट विल हैपन टू देम, सो दे वर एंश्योर्ड 10.5% डिविडेंड पर एनम बाय द गवर्नमेंट, ब्रिटिश गवर्नमेंट बैक होम इन लंदन. सो ऑल रिस्ट्रिक्शंस ऑन यूरोपियन इमिग्रेशन वर गॉन. ऑल restrictions on European immigration into India were gone, and this also paved for the whole scale European colonization. Ab proper colonization hoga India ka. Similarly, there was a kind of centralization. Centralization apne aap ho jayega. Centralization, why centralization would happen? Let me tell you that Governor General was given power to superintend, control and direct SCD, superintend, control and direct all civil, this remember this thing, this might come as a statement in your prelims, and this might you might be writing in your mains also. So superintend, control and direct all civil and military affairs of the company. कंपनी के सारे जितने भी मिलिट्री और एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव अफेयर्स हैं वो सारे के सारे कौन देखेगा? गवर्नर जनरल देखेगा। और एंड व्हाट अबाउट बंगाल, मद्रास एंड बॉम्बे प्रेसिडेंसी? दे आर ऑल प्लेस्ड अंडर कंप्लीट कंट्रोल ऑफ गवर्नर जनरल, कंप्लीट कंट्रोल, एंड ऑल रेवेन्यूज रेज टू बी रेज अंडर द अथॉरिटी ऑफ गवर्नर जनरल। गवर्नर जनरल गॉट कंप्लीट कंट्रोल ओवर द एक्सपेंडिचर। सो गवर्नर जनरल तो फिर भगवान हो गया, क्योंकि इनकम नाउ अंडर कंप्लीट कंट्रोल ऑफ गवर्नर जनरल, एक्सपेंडिचर अंडर कंप्लीट कंट्रोल ऑफ गवर्नर जनरल, पावर टू ओवरसी, सुपरिटेंड, डायरेक्ट एंड कंट्रोल द मद्रास अदर प्रेसिडेंसी एंड ऑलमोस्ट ऑल टेरिटरीज, द एंटायर टेरिटरी ऑफ इंडियन सब कॉन्टिनेंट विच वॉज नोन एज ब्रिटिश इंडिया, or which came to be known as British India, apart from the Prajamandals or the Indian states. There were certain Indian states which were supporters of Britishers, so they were left like that. So it was only after coming of Dalhousie that annexation was happening at massive level. Okay, so don't you see that centralization was happening? Okay, because now government and of Madras and Bombay, their legislative power were drastically reduced. They most of their laws would now going to be framed by Governor General. They had only just right of proposing to the Governor General, but it was on the will of Governor General what is right, what is wrong, and what is going to be. Okay, similarly, first law commission was established. First law commission was established, and it was a law member of Governor General's Council, and Macaulay became first chairman, first holder of or the chairmanship of law commission. So there might be question in the prelims, they might give some other name. So Lord Macaulay was the first chairman of first law commission of India, which was established by the Act of 1833, Charter Act of 1833. Similarly, there was this Section 87, which says that no Indian or natural born subject of the Crown, which includes Indian also, was to be denied employment under the company. It is talking about employment, that there would be no discrimination in matter of employment just on the basis of religion, place of birth, descent, color, or anything of them. But do you think it was practiced as it was written over there? No, it was not practiced, and because it was not practiced, it became we see that the early nationalists or moderates, for moderates, it was one primary point of criticism. Indianization of civil service, why they are asking for it? They are asking because this clause was not accepted in the practice. It was more seen in its violation in practice. Similar, however, there were better aspect of this act also. One better aspect was abolition of slavery, which was abolished by Act 5 of 1843 Act. Okay, so let's make a final verdict. Let's give a final verdict to the Charter Act of 1833. So it had important and far-reaching consequences, as we have seen. The company lost all its commercial powers and just became a military or administrative power or the political power. Governor General got complete control over India, and the control over India was to be in the name of British Crown. So we see at the time of independence, this the declaration of independence means the end of with the coming up of and after that, with the declaration of India as Republic, the control of British Crown or the paramountcy of British Crown, it passed into the hands of Indian people, not in the British Crown. So it completed the work of Charter Act of 1813 and complete, like we tell you, all commercial privileges were lost. More, and now it has to focus more on administrative efficiency. It was envisioned, and it also the Law Commission, the coming up of Law Commission. Why Law Commission was introduced? For the purpose of codification of laws. From now onwards, codification of laws will happen. Although it will take certain time, CRP, IPC, the Police Act, it will take some time, but the process begin from there only. Okay, so this is all about Act of 1833, and I wish you good luck for your preparation. Kindly join us. Okay, if you want to know, or if you are interested in some other topics, then we will discuss in other classes as well. Okay, good luck. Bye.